Hello everyone, welcome to Clean Coder YouTube channel. If you are new to this channel, I'll highly recommend you to subscribe to my channel as I make content related to software engineering, system design, and data structures and algorithms. This article quickly, let's read the overview. So it says, in the absence of necessary synchronizations, the compiler runtime or processor may apply all sorts of optimizations. Even though these optimizations are beneficial most of the time, sometimes they may cause subtle issues. So caching and rerouting are among these optimizations that may surprise us in concurrent context. So this concurrent is meaning of multi-threaded environments. So Java and JVM provide many ways to control memory order, and the volatile keyword is one of them. This article will focus on the foundation but often misunderstood concept in the Java language, the volatile keyword. First, we'll start with the bit of background about the underlying computer architecture and we'll get familiar. Okay, let's move forward now. This is shared multiprocessor architecture. Okay, let's start reading this. Processors are responsible for executing program instructions, therefore they need to retrieve both program instructions and required data from RAM. As CPUs are capable of carrying out significant number of instructions per second, fetching from RAM is not that ideal for them. To improve the situation, processors are using tricks like out-of-order execution, branch prediction, speculative execution, and of course caching. These are all optimizations, right? This is where the following memory hierarchy comes into play. This is the memory hierarchy or the computer architecture. So this L1 cache is closest to the core. After that, there is L2 cache, then there is L3 cache. This L1 and L2 are inside the core itself, and L3 is outside, and L3 talks to bus, which talks to RAM. So let's read the rest of the article. As different cores execute more instructions and manipulate more data, they fill up their caches, the more relevant data and instructions, right? So this will improve the overall performance at the expense of introducing cache coherence challenge, right? The cache in multiple cores is not coherent. What does coherent mean? Coherent means that they both are not in sync with each other. They don't know that what value of the shared variable is in the other cache, which is residing in other core. So some cache coherence challenges could emanate. So let's read it further. Put simply, we should think twice about what happens when thread updates a cached value. Okay. This is the example they have given to emphasize the point when we should use the volatile keyword. So let's go through this example quickly. So they have a task runner class and they have defined two static variables, a number ready. And they have a static inner class reader, which is directly extending the thread class, and it has a run variable. So there is a while loop. When we are inside this while loop, it has a method yield. What does yield do? Yield do nothing but like it signals the scheduler that you can schedule any other thread if you want. It's fine for me. So it's something like that. And once we come out of this while loop, this number is printed. So this is the main method, reader.start. This would spawn the new thread, and the number we are changing it to 42, and ready we are making it to true. So what would happen? By default, we know that this would be zero and this would be false, right? So let's read this further. The task runner class maintains two simple variables. In its main method, it creates another thread that spins on the ready variable as long as it's false true. When the variable becomes true, the thread will simply print the number variable. Many may expect this program to simply print 42 after a short delay. However, in reality, the delay may be much longer. It may even hang forever or even print zero. Yeah, that's true. This because of these anomalies is lack of proper memory visibility. Let's evaluate them in more detail. So what can happen is when will this hang in infinite loop? When this while loop would execute forever, right? When would that happen? When ready is false, right? So when ready would false, when this change is not known in this thread, right? This is the change that has happened in main thread, and this is a different thread itself. Let's call it T. So yeah, unpredictable output can happen on machine one. It's possible that this is giving the output as 42, but on machine two it's possible that the output is an infinite loop, right? So this is completely possible. Let's move forward now to the memory visibility topic. So what is the visibility then? So in this simple example, we have two application threads, the main thread and the reader thread. Let's imagine a scenario in which OS schedules those threads on two different CPU cores, where the main thread has its copy of ready and number variables in its core cache. Okay. The reader thread ends up with its copies too. The main thread updates the cached values. Yeah, this is the problem. On most modern processors, write requests won't be applied right away after they are issued. In fact, the processor tends to queue those writes in a special write buffer. So there is going to be a write buffer that is similar to a queue. So whenever there are write statements, processor would simply queue them. This is the write one. This is the write two. Something like this is going to happen, right? So this is the optimizations which gets applied. So after a while, they'll apply those writes to main memory all at once. With all that being said, when the main thread updates the number and ready variables, there is no guarantee of what the reader thread may see. In other words, the reader thread may see the updated value right away or with some delay or never at all. So yeah, the output is uncertain, may cause liveness issues in programs that are relying on visibility. So let's move to the other issue, reordering. So to make matters even worse, the reader thread may see those writes in any order. Yeah, JVM could reorder the instructions to optimize the program. So the actual order might differ. So since we first update the number variable, okay, yeah, the order could be different. We may expect the reader thread prints 42, however, it's actually possible to see 0 is the printed value. The reordering is an optimization technique for performance improvements, and interestingly, different components may apply this optimizations. So the processor may flush its write buffer in any order other than the program order, and the processor may apply out of order execution technique. JIT means just in time compiler may optimize via reordering. Yeah, different compiler or JVM level optimizations are possible. So let's move to the volatile memory order now. So ensure that the updates to variable propagate predictively to other threads, we should apply the volatile modifier to those variables. Okay, if we apply volatile, then propagation is going to happen. This way we communicate with runtime processors to not reorder any instructions involving the volatile variables. Also, processors understand that they should flush any updates to these variables right away. Yeah, they are not going to use any queues and all, and they are going to directly flush that to the main memory. Okay. Then is the next part, volatile and thread synchronization. So is that for multi-thread applications, we need to ensure a couple of rules for consistent behavior. Yeah, mutual exclusion. What does mutual exclusion mean? So we could have a critical section on which at a time only single thread should be working and rest of the threads should be blocked. or waiting till the lock is released by this thread. So this is the mutual exclusion. Visibility: changes made by one thread to the shared data are visible to the other threads to maintain data consistency. Okay, synchronized methods and blocks provide both of the above properties at the cost of application performance. Yeah, synchronization is a simple solution to volatile keywords, but like they reduce the concurrency significantly, and they should be used carefully if you are making a concurrent application. So volatile is quite useful keyword because it can help ensure the visibility aspect of the data change without, of course, providing mutual exclusion. It's useful in the places where we are okay with multiple threads executing a block of code in parallel, but we need to ensure the visibility property, right? Mutual exclusion is not our requirement, but visibility is our requirement. Then you can use the volatile keyword. So this is happens before ordering. You can skip this, like you can read this on your own, like it is further explanation. Okay, piggybacking. So piggybacking is nothing but this kind of behavior. So one variable could be volatile and rest of them could depend on that variable to have the proper functionality. So piggybacking is that concept only. So here he has only marked this ready variable as volatile and rest of the variables could survive on that. So this is what he is explaining in this paragraph. So let's conclude that. Hey guys, do check out this Instagram channel Clean Coder Community for all the jokes and memes related to software engineering. Thanks a lot.